Ông quỳ chỗ. Ông chủ tịch ra phát cam to khai tâm ra cả nội tệ thì sạm ra cả សាមណការនៅថ្ងៃនេះអង្គជំរះធ្វើសាមណការបន្តស្ដាប់ទៅខៃកម្មសសៃសៅរុនតាមរយៈប្រព័ន្ធសោទស្សន៍បញ្ចប់ហើយនឹងផ្ដើមស្ដាប់ទៅខៃកម្មសសៃដែលមានរដ្ឋនាម
សំរុបលោកវិធានសម្រាប់សវនកម្មថ្ងៃនេះក្លាមជីក៏សម្គាល់ឃើញថាក្រុមភៀកគីទាំងអស់នៃរឿងក្តីនេះមានវត្តមានលីឡៃលោកនួនជាមានវត្តមាននៅបន្ទប់ឃុំខ្លួនខាងក្រោមសាលសវនកម្មនេះដោយលោកស្នើសុំលះបង់សិទ្ធិមានវត្តមានដោយផ្ទាល់ពីបន្ទប់សវនកម្មនៅថ្ងៃនេះលិខិតលះបង់សិទ្ធិរបស់លោកនួនជាបានប្រកល់ដល់ក្លាមជីរួចហើយសាក្សីដែលនឹងត្រូវមកដល់សក្តិកម្មបញ្ចប់នៅថ្ងៃនេះគឺលោកសៅសរុន តាមរយៈប្រព័ន្ធសោទស្សន៍ពីខេត្តឧត្តរមានជ័យតាមការបញ្ជាក់ពីផ្នែកបច្ចេកទេសសោទស្សន៍បានជួនម្លងថាការរៀបចំផ្នែកបច្ចេកទេសសម្រាប់ការស្ដាប់សក្តិកម្មនៅពេលនេះបានរៀបចំរួចរាល់ហើយរីឯសាក្សីនិងមេធាវីប្រឹក្សារបស់លោកគឺលោកមឿនសុវណ្ណក៏បានត្រៀមខ្លួនជាស្រេចសម្រាប់ការផ្ដល់សក្តិកម្មនេះទៅថ្ងៃនេះដែរមាន
ដែលមានសហស្នាមពីTCCP 1116សូមអគុណលោកធានបាទអគុណលោកអែមហុយជាដំបងនេះអង្គជំរះសម្រាប់លើកតម្លើងសុំរបស់ជនជាប់ចោតនួនជាយមុនថិនអង្គជំរះបានទទួលលិខិតសុំលះបង់សិទ្ធចូលរួមក្នុងសម្ណការដែលបន្តក្នុងបន្ទប់សម្ណការនេះរបស់ជនជាប់ចោតនួនជាចុះថ្ងៃទី30ខែមីនាឆ្នាំ2016 ហើយបានបញ្ជាក់ថាដែលគាត់មានបញ្ហាសុខភាពឈឺក្បាលឈឺចង្កេះមិនអាចអង្គុយយូរបានមិនអាចផ្ចង់អារម្មណ៍បានយូរនិងដើម្បីមានលទ្ធភាពចូលរួមសកម្មភាពនៅថ្ងៃខាងមុខឲ្យមានប្រសិទ្ធភាពខ្លួនធំលះបង់សិទ្ធចូលរួមនិងមានវត្តមានដោយផ្ទាល់នៅក្នុងបន្ទប់សកម្មភាពនៅថ្ងៃទី30ខែមីនាឆ្នាំ2016បានឃើញកំណត់ហេតុពិនិត្យសុខភាពជនជាប់ចោតនួនជាដែលធ្វើឡើងដោយគ្រូពេទ្យប្រចាំការពិនិត្យព្យាបាលថែទាំសុខភាពជនជាប់ច ngày đi tham biên akara chưa từng kể chưa phải chấm ông quỳ du một bán đừng có đo ăn sát tha thôi mà ông nhập đấy ăn nhạt ở lục đồn chia cho rùm tam đàn cái chấm là cá sạm là cá vì mình túc thật được cầm xa sạn mà cá đi ai lưu mưu lụt hàn đi thằng vô tăng một bệnh nhân này bị thiên bài thập mùi pram này bị thiên tây khăn ông ô vô tổ có ông chúng tôi nhập đấy ăn nhạt ở chụp chụp cho đồn chia cho rùm nâng tam đàn cái chấm là cá sạm là cá vì chấm ngái គឺពីបន្ទប់ឃុំខ្លួនមួយស្ថិតនៅក្រោមសាលសម្ណការនេះតាមរយៈឧបករណ៍សទួសម្រាប់យកពេលសម្ណការពេញមួយថ្ងៃនេះឧបករណ៍ឯបុគ្គលិកផ្នែកសទួសជួបប្រព័ន្ធសទួសសម្រាប់ជញ្ជក់ចោលនួនជាអាចចូលរួមនឹងតាមដំណើរការសម្ណការពីចម្ងាយក្នុងឡុងពេលនៃកិច្ចដំណើរការសម្ណការសម្រាប់ថ្ងៃនេះសួស្តីលោកសៅសរុនតើលោកបានត្រៀមខ្លួនរួចរាល់ហើយឬនៅ បាទអរគុណហើយជាបន្តទៅនេះអង្គមានផ្ដល់វិទ្យការជូនទៅសហមន្ត្រីការពារក្តីដើម្បីមានឱកាសសួរដេញដោលសាក់សីហើយតំបងនេះផ្ដល់វិទ្យការជូនទៅសហមន្ត្រីការពារក្តីលោកនួនជាដើម្បីមានឱកាសសួរដេញដោលចំពោះសាក់សីសៅទរុនសូមជឿញ
Thank you, Mr. President. Good morning,
Your Honours. Good morning, Council. And
good morning, to you, Mr. Witness, and the International
Council for Nunchia.
And I would like to ask you some questions. Let me start by asking a follow-up question in relation to something you said yesterday
around 15:14.
You were asked about a meeting
between you and Pol Pot and Nunchia,
and you were asked what they told you about the Vietnamese. And at one point in time you answered, and I quote you literally, yes, they told me about that, Vietnam, and I myself witnessed the invasions along the border as well.
End of quote.
Can you explain to me what exactly it was that you witnessed? What kind of invasions along the border by the Vietnamese troops did you yourself witness?
Are you in a position to say who started the incursions, who started the fighting in Mondul Kiri
in 1976 and subsequently?
Vietnam. Vậy tạm trụng đèn kê vay muốn là hốt kê bác vay thủng tệ thống dụng đọc này một bên một cửa hàng.
The fact that the Vietnamese were the ones who started the aggression against Cambodia, was that something you witnessed yourself, or was it something that was reported to you
in your position as district secretary or as 105 secretary?
Can you give us one example of things that you witnessed yourself?
What
forms of Vietnamese aggression did you witness yourself?
នៃ ការ ឈ្លាន ពាន របស់ វៀតណាម ដែល លោក ឃើញ ដោយ ផ្ទាល់ ភ្នែក នេះ មាន លក្ខណៈ ដូច ម្តេច ដែរ
បាទ សូម ឆ្លើយ ថ្ងៃ ឯ ចូល ទ្រង់ទ្រាយ ធំ នឹង ពួក ខ្ញុំ នំ តឹងតឹង ទេ មុន ដំបូង វា ពី ប្រុស វា ចេញ ផុត ពី កង តប ការ ពៀ ព្រំដែន វា ចូល មក អែប មក ខាង ទន្លេ សេប៉ក នោះ គឺ ទៅ ណា ខ្ញុំ ក៏ បាន ទៅ រៀប ចំ កង តប ទៅ ទប់ ទល់ គ្នា kê chọn môn hôn nhé, vì rồi dưỡng con trọt buộc bần đôn kỳ rì dưỡng nhé, con trọt bọn tích tế, vì riêng mẹn bật tế chỉ chẩn nguồn, bà gà chỉ bì rõ nhẹ thế.
Mr. Witness, what was your understanding at the time as to the reasons of these constant incursions? Why was Vietnamese military troops intruding the territory all the time, invading the territory all the time? What was it that you understood the reason to be for all that?
I would like
to read to you a very small excerpt of something Sun Sen told the fellow members of the standing committee. English ERN 001
is saying
the following.
Sun Sen ban
the Vietnamese keep on coming in non-stop.
We
did not go looking to make trouble with them at all.
According to experience, they come in. When we do not chase after them,
they do not go. But when we get strict, that's when they go. That is in Ratanakiri.
In Ratanakiri,
we do not attack them at all. We respect the instructions of the party up to the point and do not let it get tense. Is that something that you, from your own experience, Who was doing those negotiations? Was that in the beginning, let me sidestep a bit. There are a lot of telegrams
about Vietnamese negotiations.
It seems that the word used for the Vietnamese troops is something called Group 7 or
Council, can you, since there are so many telegrams that deal with this, give us a reference to one or two for the record?
Look, I put all the
young to learn
ក្រុមប្រាំពីរក្រុមមួយបានទេចឹងគឺបញ្ហាតួលេខហ្នឹងតួលេខនេះក៏មានមែនប៉ុន្តែខ្ញុំអត់ដឹងថាសេចក្តីថ្មីឡើងវិញព្រោះចង់បញ្ជាក់អត្តសញ្ញាណឯកសារច្បាស់លាស់សិនហើយនឹងចំណុចពាក្យពន្ធណាអត្តសញ្ញាណឯកសារចារីការហ្នឹងខាងពីទវីទេខាងពីទវីទេត្រូវបង្ហាញមិនមែនលោកទេលោកចាំស្ដាប់ណាលោកស្ដាប់ទំនួរឲ្យច្បាស់សូមឆ្លើយតបកម្រិតត្រឹមតែពេញលិញ ចាំបាច់តបទៅនឹងសំណួរដែលសួរបានហើយក្នុងករណីសំណួរណាដែលមិនច្បាស់លាស់គឺលោកកុំអាចឆ្លើយហើយលោកសួរសុំឲ្យអ្នកតាំងសំណួរចំពោះលោកនឹងសួរលោកថាជាថ្មីសារឡើងវិញលោកយល់ទេ
answering the question of Judge Fenn, I could refer to E3/1-23. It says our brothers attacked group 7 again. I could refer to E3/1101, tracking any persons who have been contracted with the group 7 or have tendency with the group 7. E3/1/8, talking about group 7 entering, etc. Do you know what the words or the word group 7 refer to?
Lok sa say lok yul pia tha pu
One last try, let me read something that one of the experts, an American scholar, says about the use of seven. Mr. Witness, this American scholar says that Stephen Hedder, his name, he states the sevens, usually used as a code word for the Vietnamese in general, not a specific reference to People's Army of Vietnam Division 7 or the Vietnamese Communist 7th Military Zone.
So,
this scholar seems to refer Vietnamese troops in general. Does that somehow any form refresh your memory?
What counsel read does not refer to troops. What the footnote he read said sevens usually refer to Vietnamese in general. It says nothing about troops.
I think I read the excerpt, so I'm not quite sure what I just quoted him literally. Again, this American scholar seems to say that group seven, Vietnamese military, not so much group seven, but the Vietnamese military, not so much troops in general.
It doesn't say anything about military troops.
Very unlikely that Stephen Hedder meant these telegrams, but to save time.
Does it somehow refresh your memory?
And just to be clear for the record, and
objection,
in that same page, the
authors
refer to the seventh being troops. In March
78,
the independent sector 105 chief,
Mr.
President, I'm reading
an
English only excerpt from English ERN only. It's 001 69 884. It's called a report on the 2 March 78 Socialist Republic of Vietnam intrusion in
Mondul Kiri.
At 600 hours on 2 March, the Vietnamese forces stationed in our territory at Dak Nam, Mondul Kiri, inside our territory. We ambushed and killed 16 of them. Survivors fled back in disorder, leaving behind 7 dead. We see 2 AKs, 2 machine guns,
3 M72s.
And a basket of rice. Still wants to annex
Cambodia.
It has also continued to encroach along the Khmer border, entering our territories, shelling and pounding it, and sending spies and commandos to launch spying, espionage, and sabotage activities and destroying property, rice fields, and crops of our people in the border area. Therefore, our people have continued to raise high provocative and aggressive activities on what we need for everything, Cambodian territory,
sovereignty, honor, and territorial integrity.
My question, Mr. Witness, is broadcast radio
program
reflecting, yes or no, your experience of the situation the broadcast speaks about
Is there anything that you can tell us?
Let me see if I can give you an example
that
potentially might refresh your memory.
Mr.
President, I'll be referring to E3/790. It's the summary of a statement
that
was by me before of a Division 9, 120 military person. Mr. Witness, this 920 Division soldier talks about the so-called Kampun movement,
or
the rebellion movement, and he is saying that
Kampun
brought Vietnamese into territory of Democratic Cambodia through the person yesterday, Svai, and he is saying that these were secretly kept near villages or near the village. Do you know anything about Kampun, Svai and others secretly assisting Vietnamese troops and bringing them into
the
Vietnamese
territory?
Was it mainly Division 920 and Division 801 that were involved in dealing with Vietnamese aggression, Vietnamese attempts to sabotage? Was it primarily those two divisions' tasks to deal with the Vietnamese? Mr. Witness, are you there?
Lok sa sai lok kopong tae nou chmuoy yeung rư ot dai lok.
Mr. Witness, did you hear my question?
Lok sa sai lok sdap lư samnuo khnyom dae.
Min banha
Mr. Witness, my question was Which telegrams contain the words of
7 1 0 3 0
written by Sophia.
Witness,
that's the Sophia I believe that you discussed yesterday. And the reason I'm reading this
program
to you is because it deals with the district that you at the time were chief of. And let me read to you what Sophia wrote to beloved and
Mr. John, who
we're not sure know who he is, that could be lying or dumb. But it doesn't matter. What he writes is the following. On the 21st of July, 1977, the seven group that attacked us at Pechenda
has now attacked and entered
Tree Class Village and Tung Village and the De'e Village. There were 30 of them. We are now organizing forces to
ambush. So,
this is a telegram about your district when you were the district chief, and Sophia is reporting an attack of the seven group at Pechenda.
Does
that now maybe refresh your memory?
No
problem, Mr. Witness. I will move on. No problem. I will move on. The Congress of the CPK in 2012, before 2012,
before 2012,
refer you to, for instance, English ERN
0004-003025.
Khmer 0039-84-80-0048-419. You talked about the Great Congress. Sure. Was this the 18th anniversary party congress of the CPK?
Nih kư chia mahasanabat lek kư chia khub pak komunist Kampuchea rư ko lek ti 18 rư ko yang na.
បាទគឺសន្និបាតនឹងគឺសន្និបាតប្រចាំឆ្នាំបាទអានឹងគឺដូចខ្ញុំបានរៀបការជូនថ្ងៃមុនហើយសន្និបាតប៉ានឹងកំណត់បាល់ទូទាំងប្រទេសគ្រប់ស្ថាប័នតាំងពីខាងសាវើតាំងពីខាងទាហានគឺចូលសន្និបាតប៉ា
Do you agree with me that the 18th Congress or the 18th anniversary, sorry, of victory, the founding of the Communist Party of Kampuchea was held between 18 September. And 30 September.
Was it a 12-day congress?
Was the Congress in September? Was it a few days? And did it celebrate the 18th anniversary of the founding of the CPK? In the revolutionary flag, that Pol Pot gave and that you referred to fully covered in the revolutionary magazine. It's And let me specifically refer you to something he said about Vietnamese Pol Pot and about Vietnam. Vietnam and Vietnam's policy, that he made a distinction between
Vietnam.
On the one hand, the word Vietnamese people,
Vietnam,
and on the other hand, when he was speaking about Vietnam as foreign policy, he only then would use the word Yun. Is that something that you could agree with?
ตาลูกยลสรอบนตรองจำนวนนี้เต้
บ้ายลสรอบ
Now this is a speech to hundreds of comrades of yours. Was this also something he did when he spoke to you in person?
รวมหมดบอลโลกนู้นรอบร้อยปอนเนี่ยตาตาตากดไลน์ยังไม่ได้โลกคลุนโลกตอลบ้านสนับโดยตอลได้ตี
I understand, Mr. Williams. Yesterday, you said that Pol Pot did not hate the Vietnamese people, but he hated the Vietnamese aggressor. Is that something he only said in public speech, or was that something he also said when he was speaking to you in private?
ឬក៏យ៉ាងណាបាទឥឡូវគឺគាត់ថ្លែងការនេះគឺមិនជាក់ក្នុងពេលប្រជុំនោះទេយើងអត់ខឹងអត់ប្រឆាំងជនជាតិវៀតណាមទេពីប្រជាជនវៀតណាមមិនជាអ្នកឈ្លានពានទេគឺប្រឆាំងកងទ័ពវៀតណាមជាអ្នកឈ្លានពានគាត់ថ្លែងការចឹងមែន
What was your experience between 75 or 79?
នៅពេលដែលប្រើពាក្យយួននៅពេលដែលយើងនិយាយសំដៅទៅលើថាប្រជាជនវៀតណាមគឺយើងមិនស្អប់ទេប៉ុន្តែបើប្រើពាក្យយួនគឺយើងស្អប់យួនឈ្លានពានតាមបទពិសោធន៍របស់លោកលោកយល់ដូចម្ដេចដែរអានេះគឺយល់អញ្ចឹងទេតាមយើងភាគច្រើនគេយល់អញ្ចឹងគេថាចង់ការពីថាយួនដូចគេថាយើងខ្មែរកម្ពុជាមានចឹងយួនឈ្លានពានអ្នកខ្លះ
Let me read to you an excerpt from Pol Pot's speech.
And then I will ask you whether you remember.
Him or New Year's private conversations. Again, It says as follows: the strategy of the international expansionists' attempt to seize Cambodia reappeared.
They want to be a great power in the region, and they want to be a great power in Southeast Asia.
hay kê chẳng khai chia Việt Nam chẳng khai chia bà tê đại khai hiệp phát nơ dìa khăn nê dìm nay bộ sô viết vĩnh đại miên cô lùm nông chẳng cổ rộng vi phục lô tay mặt đoàn nó cứ kê chẳng cổ rộng à dì khăn nê tạm ọc tay mặt đoàn hay dùn nâng Việt Nam ní
Thus they became very angry. In late 77, they began to strike our Cambodia in a very large scale with both the UN and the Soviet international expansionists and their peak. And then he's talking about 14 military divisions of Vietnam involved.
Mr. Witness, is that something that
you can remember? Is that something that... Do you remember when you heard that whether you
were thinking
his views were accurate or that they were reflecting what you yourself had experienced as well?
Khmer, sorry, also for my benefit, because frankly, I'm not sure I understand what you want to know. You want to know what he thought when he heard the speech?
Yeah, Krom fans. លោកមេធាវីលោកចង់ដឹងពីយោបល់របស់សាស្ត្រីពេលដែលគាត់ស្ដាប់ឬសន្ទរកថានឹងតាមពិតខ្ញុំចង់ដឹងពីការយល់ឃើញរបស់គាត់អំពីខ្លឹមសារនៃសន្ទរកថាវិញលោកមេធាវីបើខ្ញុំសូមធ្វើ
ហើយនឹងសហភាពសូវៀតបាទយល់ស្របពីប្រវេសគាត់បញ្ជាក់ច្បាស់ណាស់ទឹកដល់របស់គេនឹងគឺលេខយកកម្ពុជាចូលក្នុងសហព័ន្ធរួមចិនគាត់បញ្ជាក់អញ្ចឹងតែយើងចិត្តស្ដាប់ឃើញយើងដូចជាស្ដែងយើងទៅវាយតាមលុកតាមព្រំដែនជារៀងរហូតអានឹងគេថាតាមលុកប្រព័ន្ធគាត់
Now, Mr. Witness, only 3 months later,
Vietnam
back in the Soviet Union.
Vietnam đã miễn các công trô phí sắp hiệp sổ viết bằng tòa phí bàn cho dân ta thị ca dự thiê cho mùi thế này nút phát bàn chốt mà chỉ liên biên bà tây Campuchia nấu bế nút ở bọn cuộc phí là bọn bay này
bắt cùng đi Campuchia
គេបានត្រៀមលក្ខណៈដើម្បីទប់ទល់នឹងការឈ្លានពានរបស់វៀតណាមតើលោកដឹងដែរឬទេថាបីខែក្រោយមកវៀតណាមពិតប្រកាសជាមានបំណងចូលមកឈ្លានពានប្រទេសកម្ពុជាហើយបានមកកាន់ការប្រទេសកម្ពុជារយៈពេល10ឆ្នាំទៀតផងតើត្រឹមត្រូវដែរឬទេ
បាទត្រឹមត្រូវ
Maybe I'll reformulate my questions. Do you know whether in Mondulkiri or in Sector 105
preparation
for any Vietnamese invasion which would indeed happen 3 months later?
Dambai Toptol Nangka Chilean Pien Robo Vietnam Ban Thu Lang Bai Khai Karoi Pi Pol Pot Lang San Karatha Nang.
And what kind of preparations? And do you remember what preparations were taken in Mondulkiri? Or in Sector 105 to stop Vietnam from invading Cambodia?
Were you involved in the preparations?
ក្រោយពីសេចក្តីថ្លែងការណ៍ឯកបានត្រៀមរៀបចំកងទ័ពដើម្បីទប់ទល់តាមលទ្ធភាពនៅរៀងអភិបាលពីប្រកបតបតំបន់នេះជាកងទ័ពតិចទេប្រទៀមលក្ខណៈសម្បត្តិដើម្បីរួមសហការគ្នាកងពលគេបាទចាំអស់
Do you know whether the troops in 105 actually had a chance against the Vietnamese invaders?
ឋានិឋានមិនបានទេពីប្រុសគេមិនទេធំយើងទេតូចកងតបតិចហើយក្រអាវុធសត្រាក៏មិនទំនើបមិនសម្បូរបែបហើយអាកំសឹងទំនើបទំនើបមានប្រទេសនំទាំងចេះប្រើនំទាំងបានមានកិច្ចកទេសឯងសត្យយោប្រយោជន៍ទីស្រុកស្រែតចម្បាំងចប់សង្គ្រាមហើយគេថាលើក គោលការណ៍ទី1ស្ដារសេដ្ឋកិច្ចទី2ការពារទឹកដីគេយកសេដ្ឋកិច្ចនេះជាខុសទី1វិញអញ្ចឹងមិនរឿងការពារទឹកដីនេះក៏វាការពារដែរប្រទេសទាំងអាវុធសត្រាក៏វាកសោយខាងតំបន់ខាងកងពលទេគេមានអាវុធសត្រាមួយខាងតំបន់អត់មានទេមានត្រឹមការពារម្ដងទេមានដល់ទី
Thank you, Mr. Witness. Let me turn to another subject that was discussed, according to you, during this 18th anniversary
Congress in September. That was
the guideline of July 1978 that would give amnesty to certain types of enemy. Do you remember this amnesty guideline?
And what is it that you remember now about this?
ការខុសសកងឬក៏ផុនច្រឡំអីអានឹងក៏អោយលើកលែងទោសលោកយើងការចាប់មិនអោយមានការចងទេអានឹងគេប្រកាសទូទាំងប្រទេសហ្នឹងលោកពលពតក៏ប្រកាសបន្តមាត់គាត់ហ្នឹងអោយទៅមើលមកណែនាំធ្វើមិនអាចគេប្រែយើងប្រទេសខ្មែរយើងធ្វើឲ្យមិនគ្រប់ដៃរួមជើងអានឹងលក់ទឹកលក់ដៃឲ្យបរទេស
Now this guideline was already issued in July 1978.
And
you said it was handed out during that 18th anniversary Congress. Do you remember whether you already knew about this in July 1978 rather than only in September 1978? But my question is, did you first learn of it in July 1978 or did you first learn about it during the 18th anniversary Congress? Thank you, Mr. Witness. Let me refer now to
Do you remember saying that betraying the Vietnamese aggressor, the Vietnamese enemy?
ណាត់គេគឺអសុំចលៃញេថាវត្តទៀតគេសំដៅថាអ្នករួមដៃរួមជើងជាមួយខ្មាំងចតរបស់ប្រទេសយើងគេចាំសំដៅញេអញ្ចឹងឯណានរួមដៃរួមជើងត្រូវសកម្មភាពដើម្បីបង្កិចបំផ្លាញអធិបតេយ្យភាពរបស់ប្រទេសទាំងដៃរបស់ខ្លួនអានឹងគេពាក្យថាសំដៅញេអានឹង
Let me read to you an excerpt from something
Sun Sen told all the
vision commanders in October 1976, and it deals with the enemy situation, both external
He is discussing with the division commanders.
They must be educated again and again in the category three, the category of those merely being incited by the enemy, merely believing in the enemy incitement.
Can you give a reaction to this?
ແລະການບໍ່ສົນເຊນຈັ່ງແມ່ນກໍຖ້າຍັງມັນແມ່ນຖ້າເຈດຖ້າເຖີປິດເວຍປິດກາເດຕໍ່ຕາມັນກາອົບລົມຕໍ່ຄໍາມະນຸດເຈິງເວຈະຕະຄິດຕະພຽງຕໍ່ເຈດຕະອົບລົມຕໍ່ອົດຕິນຕໍ່ຕໍ່ບັນຈີອັນຈັ່ງມີແມ່ນໃບປະເພດຈັ່ງແມ່ນກໍບັນຈີຈະບາມັນແມ່ນຖ້າເຈດຕໍ່ອ້ອຍຈັບຈັ່ງຕໍ່ອ້ອຍຈອງເດອ້ອຍອົບລົມຈະທີ 1
Mr. Witness, you were quite close to Division 920 and to Tasan. Do you know whether in about a period that Ham or Lang was murdered by Kampun?
About 100
Division 920 soldiers were released from S-21. Let
me ask it differently. Do you know whether at one point in time
Division 920 soldiers were arrested,
interrogated and then subsequently released from Phnom Penh?
For the record, Mr. President, I refer to E3/86448,
which is
But in your conversations with Tassan, Division 920 commander, did he ever speak about
Division
920 soldiers being arrested and subsequently released again? This amnesty guideline in July 78.
Was
that a confirmation of the existing policy in terms of money, or was it a change of policy? Are you in a position to say what exactly the amnesty guideline of July 78
implied?
I apologize again, Mr. Witness, it may be a difficult question.
Was it a policy
បាទអរគុណលោកមេធាវីបាទអរគុណលោកសាក់សីឥឡូវនេះដល់ពេលសម្រាកហើយលោកសាក់សីលោកមេធាវីអាចសម្រាកបានហើយរហូតដល់ម៉ោង10កន្លះសូមបន្តកិច្ចដំណើរការសម្ដនការរបស់យើងហើយសូមមកកាន់កន្លែងផ្ដោតខែកម្មតាមប្រព័ន្ធតទួលនៅទីនោះបាទឥឡូវនេះដល់ពេលសម្រាកហើយអរគុណលោកសាក់សីឥឡូវនេះដល់ពេលសម្រាកហើយលោកសាក់សីលោកមេធាវីអាចសម្រាកបានហើយរហូតដល់ម៉ោង10កន្លះសូមបន្តកិច្ចដំណើរការសម្ដនការរបស់យើងហើយសូមមកកាន់កន្លែងផ្ដោតខ